Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode, we don't have many Starship updates, but we'll begin by looking at some Starlink stuff. Then we have various bits happening in Boca Chica, including SN7 testing and updates on further testing dates. Let's head straight in and get up to date. As I said, we are starting today with Starlink, and as you can see on the SpaceX fans website, there is a launch happening soon. Starlink 9 was originally going to launch on Tuesday, but should now lift off on Thursday 25th at 8:39pm UTC or 4:39pm EDT. The booster B1051 should launch for the fifth time to deliver the 10th batch of Starlink satellites into orbit. Hopefully, it will then become the second booster to land for the fifth time. Also on Starlink, some shots of the user terminals have been captured. Otherwise known as UFOs on a stick, these little terminals will be used for connecting with the satellites. Mary captured these great shots from her backyard, and it seems like SpaceX is doing a lot of testing, which makes sense since I believe their beta testing program will start soon. Not too many SpaceX updates, so now let's see the action over in Boca Chica. Starting with a recent drive-by of the whole SpaceX facility, here you can see the latest view of the Starship Superheavy launch pad construction. Just behind the fence, you can see what I started to think could be pipes. Although, on second glance, I think they could be some sort of beams for the structure they are building. Last episode, we saw this new rebar structure being put together. The rebar tube was spotted being oriented into the upright position to be placed into the foundations. I'm very excited to see what it is that they are building here, as I have some guesses and it's likely going to be one absolutely colossal building. Workers have also been spotted lowering this giant rebar tube into the hole recently dug by the auger. Hopefully soon we might start to see what this could potentially be. Next up we have the launch stand, which has had some new additions. You can see now that the railings which have been added are now pretty much complete. Still no SN5 sitting on top of it yet though, but as you will find out soon, that's going to change shortly. The NSF team highlighted the new structure we were seeing near the fuel farm. Retaining wall foundation is apparently what it is and will prevent erosion. The enormous new Manitowoc crane has also had further work to put it together. It's beginning to grow, but there are a whole bunch more components to be attached, I believe. An interesting change that has been spotted is the methane flare stack. They had recently removed it, I believe, and were planning to use a different method of dealing with the excess propellant. Musk previously tweeted in May about recondensing using solar power as opposed to burning it off. However, as you can see here, they have since reinstated the flare stack. Something else that was spotted was a shipping container with a blue sign on it under Starhopper. The sign says, "Future home of SpaceX Launch Control Center." So we already know what they are planning to build here, and will be interesting to see when they properly begin constructing it. There are lots of infrastructure and very little Starship updates at the moment. Just a little thing to add is something that I could only dream of being able to do. Here you can see SpaceXers enjoying their lunch under the shade of the giant Starhopper vehicle. Whilst not very much, we do have a little bit of Starship stuff today. Here you can see a nose cone with thrusters sitting in one of the onion tents, and I believe this is one of the newer noses. A few days ago, Austin Bernard tweeted a picture of SN7 after it was prepared for the next round of testing. Musk responded to the tweet with, "All patched up." Then yesterday, SpaceX used one of their backup dates to begin testing the little tank. As expected, they did another test of failure, except this time it seemed like a hop. The pop, which appears to have been caused by the bottom dome, sent the whole tank and its stand flying. Here's a great view of the aftermath of the test, and wow, did SN7 get wrecked. Unfortunately, Elon Musk has yet to give us any information about the test or what sort of pressure it reached. Hopefully, this time they exceeded the 8 bar mark. The next lot of testing coming over the next few weeks should be SN5, including potentially a hop soon. Now we have some information on further testing dates. In this document it says that the road will be closed for an hour today between 6 a.m. and 7 a.m. CST. There have been a bunch of date changes recently, but right now we have today, June 24th, for rollout. Then it looks like testing will begin on Monday, June 29th, with dates up to July 1st. The final thing I'll show you is a new FAA filing for flight restrictions. As you can see, SpaceX have requested this so they can probably perform the 150-meter hop. The document has dates for the restriction of between Wednesday, June 24th and Wednesday, July 8th. Not the longest video today, but some very exciting updates on testing. As always, I want to say a massive thank you to Mary Boca Chica girl, who spends whole days outside filming history for us fans. Also, the NASA spaceflight team does some amazing work with the live streams and all other space coverage, so huge thanks to them as well. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.